I'm Ralph Blumenthal. This is an excerpt from my book, The Believer, on Harvard psychiatrist John Mack, who scandalized Harvard with his research into alien abduction. Abductees were frequently taken from their bedrooms during sleep, Mack wrote, but also from other locations, indoors and out. Kathy, a 25-year-old employee of the U.S. Drug Enforcement Administration, was found in a field near her flipped-over snowmobile after being missing for an hour and a half. Her coat, hat, scarf, and gloves were found neatly folded nearby. Later, under hypnosis, details of an abduction experience came back to her. It usually began, Max said, with the sighting of a craft that could be remembered as a helicopter, van, bus, or other vehicle. A bright light, a humming or buzzing sound, and the terrifying materialization of small humanoid figures, sometimes also appearing as deer, owls, or other animals. Abductees might feel transported on a ramp or beam of light through closed doors and windows and onto a ship, seeing their home recede below. They said they felt paralyzed, numb and powerless, and intensely afraid. Witnesses, on the other hand, were commonly switched off, unable to interfere, and often completely oblivious. But sometimes relatives or friends were abducted together and recognized each other on the ships. The beings were commonly described as robotic or bug-like little guys, 3.5 to 4 feet tall, with grayish leathery skin and form-fitting gray or blue jumpsuits or robes, he said. There were also slightly larger figures, often called doctors, who seemed in charge of the smaller beings and the abduction process. The small beings had smooth pear-shaped heads that tapered to pointy chins and protruded to the back, as well as thin lines for mouths, holes for noses, skinny necks and arms, and hands with 3 or 4 fingers. The legs were rarely described, and the feet seemed encased in boots. The most striking features were the eyes, enormous elliptical black orbs. Communication was telepathic. "It's just in my head," Max said he often heard from experiencers. The craft interiors were commonly described as curved and gleaming, white, with slab-like examining tables. Experiencers often reported glimpses of screens, terminals, medical machines, maps, symbols, and debris. Some found the air on the ships clammy or stale. Inside, the abductees recalled being subject to an array of invasive medical procedures with instruments often described in vivid detail.